Yesterday, we were shite. Today, we are losers. Welcome back to Big Stevie Cool 1872. And that man, that baldy man, Stephen Naismith, has led in two Rangers in his presser today. And is he wrong? Is he right? Let's dissect it. And he's went on to say, there are a number of players who have been there over the years and have failed to win trophies. You know what? You can't even deny it. He's right. The Rangers team is full of losers, man. But, right, we have had a really pish week, right? It's been absolute mince. Let's not try and spin it, all right? We have bottled the league title, right? Bottled it. Absolutely thrown it away. And you know what I mean? I can accept losing a league. I can. I mean, we've lost enough over the years. But, you know, it's always the same old manner, isn't it? This bottling pish, especially ever since Gerrard came in. But it's like, right, okay, the team's pish. They bottle it on the big occasion. This team has literally been called shite by one of their own players and also a pack of losers, essentially, by a former player in Stephen Naismith. If that doesn't get this team firing on Sunday, I don't know what will. Will they get fired on Sunday, fired up? I mean, probably not. Probably not. And that's the frustrating thing. It's just an absolute mess. The Rangers, now Naismith did go on to say that we carried a bit of luck in our good run, but here, most teams in a run, right, carry luck. There's an element of luck in every team in football, right? But, yeah, that's not to suggest that teams in the past, you know, Arsenal's Invincibles, there's a bit of luck in there, of course there is. Real Madrid won 3 Champions Leagues in a row, of course there is. When Celtic do quadruple trebles and all that, there's a wee bit of luck in there, all right? See, when we won Title 55, you get that wee extra bit of luck in there, you do. See, when we got to the Europa League final, there's that extra wee bit of luck in there. But the reality is, this team has fucking disgraced themselves in the past 2 games, and I'm sick of it. And see, when people spin a narrative that you don't support a team when you're overly negative, how can anyone be overly positive about Rangers at the minute? You know, I thought the writing was on the wall after that Old Firm game, and we're talking about this team bottling it, right? Could it be that game against Celtic was just the epicenter, and that was the beginning of the end for this season? You just got blown away in that first half, and that's it. Because I tell you what, if we replicate what we have done in the last 3 games, now, yeah, the second half at Ibrox was a bit better, but against Celtic, I think, you know, they kind of replicated what we did in the first half, just not as bad. If we replicate the way we've played pretty much in the last 3 games the rest of this season, we are just walking away with a League Cup this season. We will get beat by Hearts on Sunday. We will not win this league. The league's over, all right? Unless there is a total change around, I think it's over. I do. I could not explain the happiness I would feel if we somehow turned it around for this position. But I actually physically don't think we can. It's like even teams in the past that have lost the league. I mean, I'm not thinking of the recent years because, I mean, it's a lot of the core still there. But, you know, you think in the past, right, when you're younger and shit, and, you know, real leaders in there, like Barry Ferguson, players like that. If we were 3 points behind Celtic with 5 games to go, I think you would have so much more faith, man. And we are, like, if you actually look at it, right, there's 5 games to go. We're 3 points behind. Forget about the last 2 games. Disaster. Absolutely. But there's 5 games to go. We're 3 points behind Celtic. Both teams have a tough run in, right? Now, yeah, we've got the more away games, but realistically, it's still technically in our hands, even though if we do win all of our 5 games, there's still a real possibility that we win the league, right? Still in our own hands to a degree, and we are sitting here 3 points behind Celtic, pretty much all of us feeling like we've got no chance. That just tells you everything that you need to know about this band of players. It does. Because if they were anything good, if they were anything half decent, we'd be sitting here like, yeah, we're 3 points behind, but I've got faith in this team that they can fight and dig in the trenches and get the job done, at least make a fight here. See, come the 3rd match day, I would be shocked almost if we're only 3 points behind Celtic. I think it'll be more. I think we're going to get pumped by Hearts. And this isn't a match preview. And I say pumped, I don't think we're going to get beat like 6-0. But if we perform the way we have in the last couple of games, Hearts will put us to the sword. They haven't beat us in a while. And, you know, they've got a good team. Great striker. I wish he was our striker. less said about that, the better. But here, it's going to be all over. If we perform the way we have done recently against Hearts and continue into the split, this season is going to go from awful to great to back to awful. And what I mean by great is, not too long ago, there's talk of a quad. Yes, at least there was a talk of a quad in March, right? Even though the Europa League was always unrealistic, but the treble up to about bloody quarter past about 1 o'clock on last Sunday, treble was looking good, man. You're like, yeah, this Rangers team's going along, all right. The league's still looking good. It's in our hands. You know, we're ahead of Celtic. We win these two games and they bottled it. The arses went. You look at Motherwell when you beat 2-1. Bottled. And that's where the rot started, man. You know, that was a game to go 5 points clear. And against fucking, nothing against Motherwell, man. But a Rangers team in the past would have blew, Motherwell away, man, and went 6 or 5 points clear or whatever. But no. That was our time to put the pressure on Celtic. And you know, and Celtic will be feeling like in that game against Hearts that there wasn't a lot of, not pressure. Like, but imagine, man, imagine if Celtic were going into that game against Hearts that weekend on the 2nd and 3rd of March, whatever. If they were going into that match, man, knowing, holy shit, we're 5 points behind. It's almost like, you know, it was, they did let us off the hook, but it didn't become that crucial for them at the end of the day. So, you know, sad, like, but is what it is. That's a good night there. I got a hole in my hoodie there and I just fucking ripped it. It's force of habit, like, don't even know why I did it, to be perfectly honest. But anyway, guys, that's the hoodie in the bin. I like the title. But yeah, we're done. Till next time. Are we losers? It's time for this team to step up to task. I've not much faith they will. Till next time, though. Peace.